I said you giving up good shit. We're not even rolling. You know what I mean? So, yes, we had a delay tonight because we had some audio difficulties, but we're on the air, ready to go. Can you speak into the microphone just so I can...
I am. Fuck, man.
Wow. Well, welcome to the Moragne's. I am Diami, and this is...
Shit, we've been at this for like 10 minutes already.
Okay, but who are you? Can you tell the people who you are? You spicy this episode. Let's go.
Nah, it's just...
You don't want to tell the people who you are?
Ignorant ass people.
Who's ignorant?
You.
Why?
You still like, I'm hearing shit, and you getting mad at me for your shit being janky.
Wait, who am I mad at? I'm in a good mood.
You giving me attitude, like speaking to the mic.
It's called a mic check. You know, we do it
I was speaking.
Hella,
but you ain't got to give me attitude.
Away. You was giving the microphone social distancing, and then you want to have a low-ass voice. That doesn't work out. But who are you? Tell the people who you are. Let them know.
Mimi.
Mimi? Mimi who?
Moragne. Like,
all right, there we go. Why you say it like that? Moragne? You say like you held hostage or some shit.
Might as well.
Yeah, you feel like you a hostage? Look, you can't even keep a straight face.
Nah, because I know you're going to start with your dramatic shit right now, so you know what?
What dramatic? You speak on it, Mac 10, speak on it.
Dramatic at times.
Okay. I guess I'll hold the dramatic part of that. But how you been? How was your week?
Long.
It was. It was a long week.
Long, motherfucker.
Yeah.
But I made it through. Well, we got one more day.
Yeah.
It's like we there anyway, so.
Uh-huh.
You know, the hardest part of the week is done.
That's true. That's true. What was your greatest accomplishment this week?
Going every day of the week.
To the gym?
Yeah, I did go every day of the week.
Yeah, you did. You banged it out every day.
No, I didn't go on Monday.
No, Monday. You missed Monday. That's right. That's right.
Fuck.
But Tuesday through Friday, it's all good.
Yeah. Missed some good workout days.
Monday, that AC, or Sunday night, the AC was, or Saturday night, actually, the AC was on.
Mm-hmm.
So Sunday, La Reina over here laid up.
La Reina acting like you ain't benefiting.
La Reina laid
over
up.
Over here under blankets and shit.
It's cold. You got this motherfucker like a cave. I came in Monday morning. It's like 4 something in the morning. I get up, get ready for, you know, the job and whatnot. I start making my coffee. I go outside. I come back in, and it's cold like a cave, and then I just hear a whole lot of good sleep. I go to my son's room. He's low-key snoring, you know, under the blankets. He's knocked out getting that good sleep. I hear your pops doing his thing. I go in my bedroom, Junior snoring, and you knocked out with the good sleep, too. The whole house, only your mom was up.
Like today, Tito was snoring.
Yeah, getting that good sleep with that air conditioning. So what I was saying was, you were so relaxed and laid up Saturday night through, you know, Monday morning, that I don't think your body was ready to go to the gym. Your body was still kind of like in a comatose. I've been refrigerated for a whole weekend type of shit. It was cold in here, babe. It gets cold.
I'm still adjusting that shit, but I ain't going over 76. Fuck that. Might as well be like we were.
What are you talking shit. About? That's crazy. I mean, you don't think 76 is a cool temperature? That's like cool.
I don't want to feel no type of sweat on my body. No moisture, nothing. Like,
what?
To me, you know I sweat.
Queen Elizabeth type of shit is that? What are you
You know I sweat easily, and I hate that feeling of, you know, sweat trickling down. Like, ugh, no. I'm good.
You swear like you just walking around the house perspiring like that. That's crazy.
I'm doing shit.
What are you doing that makes you sweat?
You know,
sweat?
Like cooking? Cleaning the restroom?
Okay, so hold
vacuuming,
on.
Vacuuming, mopping,
hold
sweeping.
On.
Like, what else you want?
I cook. And the
I'm
only
I'm going to start cleaning the walls soon, so what?
Okay, hey. I love it, Karen White. Be my superwoman. I love it. I love it. And that's why you got the AC.
So why you ask?
I'm just asking. I've never really seen you perspire
whatever
now when okay. The house was hot yes But just walking around regular, I never really saw you get like that.
No, well, yeah, doing so that's shit. Like,
no, you make it sound like you just I'm walk around like, and just from the
I
motion.
I open the door and I fucking start sweating.
Yeah, from the
like,
motion and the force that you exert, that you just start sweating over here. That's what you make it sound. Yes, we lived in a hot-ass house, and you would perspire when you would do those type of things. But the way you made it sound that was like, you know, you have some abnormal body temperature and you
it's just when I'm doing
you put your drawers on and
you know when I'm cleaning around the house, you know, it's hot.
So can we say maybe when you're not cleaning to not have it on? How about we make a rule, if it's on, you gotta clean or cook. How's that sound?
That, I guess that applies to you too.
What do you mean? I'm not
you go outside and do something, you could come inside and get a little bit of air.
I'm not in the house. I'm in the garage.
I'll have that motherfucker on when I want. You know, as a matter of fact, I was going to put that shit down, the setting, but fuck that.
Oh, out of spite, you're going to higher the temperature?
Really going to feel like a cave.
it's cold, babe.
Whatever, it's comfortable for me.
Yeah.
You could always put a blanket on.
And I have to. I need to get... Where's the good Mexican blankets?
And what's the only way you can get...
Get what?
Cool. If you're hot.
Huh? What's the
you
only
can
way...
Put a, yeah, you can put a blanket on.
Right. Yes. But the problem is, it gets so cold in the middle of the night, then you sneak over and take the blanket, and then I wake up literally fucking shivering, and you over there knocked out again with the good sleep, and I got a little thin-ass sheet wrapped around my ankle. So that shit is foul.
You know what? Where's the blanket up there? Get that blanket.
That's what I'm asking. Where's it at?
It's right there.
Is it one of the good ones? Don't give me one of those old raggedy ones with holes in it. None of that stuff. Because it's cold in there.
We need to get a bed, too.
We need to get a bed.
Yes. I ordered already the thing, we just need to buy the mattress. I don't want to get it.
Wait, we didn't even discuss.
We're discussing it now.
Wait, so you just making moves like that, huh?
Like, you act like we don't need a new bed.
We do.
A mattress, that's all we need.
Okay.
You swear I'm going to go buy it. Well, I need the bedding too, but...
Well, you hit me with some $800 sheets or some crazy shit. What was that?
$140. Yes, but I didn't end up getting those.
For some sheets.
Yes, because I need my body. I don't need it to be, you know, hot.
All right, we are not even 10 minutes into this episode, and twice you have mentioned that your body doesn't like sweat. Your body requires a certain type of sheets.
When I sleep, I want to be comfortable. I don't want to wake up because the sheets are too hot.
Ah, so you need the right temperature sheets.
Yes.
Okay. That's
but cool. Actually ended up, since we have the AC.
I grew up poor, so I slept on no sheets.
Oh, trust me, we did too.
I slept on no sheets.
But we in Chino now, motherfucker, so...
We made it. You on, huh? You like, I'm on. Let me get
my
100.
Like, you ain't comfortable.
What do you mean?
Like,
when do I ever complain?
So let us go back to eating a bolillo and a baked potato.
Yes, word to Parkview. Yes.
Okay,
yes.
So
no, I've come a long way.
Now?
But would I? I would tear one up if I could.
You would tear one up, but
yes.
Every day?
Nah, not
okay,
every day.
Exactly.
Not
exactly.
Because I want
to be able to be
I now have.
I don't.
I now have more
for
myself.
For
but there's nothing wrong with that.
I don't want
that.
New cars. I don't want the latest purses and, you know, shoes and shit. No.
Yeah.
Make me comfortable. Fuck.
You, no. What
my
it's,
comfort
again?
Is,
it's not really
is
about
here,
the
my home.
My, it's my understanding of why sheets are $140, not the
because
price.
Because it makes it's a temperature. You know, for the temperature for your body. It's
so
like,
are these like temperature control sheets? Like if
yes.
you want them, so
no, you, no, no. You don't. You can't make them fucking cold and hot.
Well,
no.
Then what's the point?
It's just, it's your body. A lot of these sheets, if
right.
you buy cheap sheets,
okay,
it makes you sweaty and hot, and it
okay
it elevates your body right. temperature. Therefore, it makes you sweaty.
So is that why that?
So these, like when you get 100% bamboo sheets.
Wait, hold on. So beep beep. 100% what?
Bamboo sheets.
Bamboo, like
They help.
Like what the pandas eat?
Organic and shit. Yeah.
Really? So they're bamboo sheets. Isn't bamboo like some endangered shit? Isn't it?
I don't know, but shit.
You over here on... You over
it's
here.
Not illegal to have it on Amazon unless Amazon's slanging like that.
Hey, Jeff Bezos is a motherfucker, so... You know,
I mean, it has a warranty anyway, so if I don't like it within 90 days... I'm gonna wash our DNA off and return them.
Ugh, so we would keep sheets for 90 days, have your ass crack in them and stuff like that?
No, I would know within the first 2 days or three if the sheets ain't for me.
Okay.
So I'll wash those shits and send them back.
Got you.
Give me my money and then I'll buy the $140
So is it the thread
ones.
Count that's important? Because I remember that one time you had me in a store for like 30 minutes looking for a fucking thread count. I'd never done that before.
Yes. I was trying to be the... economical way, but that ain't working, so it's not really quality out there. And so that's why I'm just seeing.
So would you be willing, if anybody is listening who has maybe a bed making, a bed sheet company, would you be willing to, you know, possibly look into some of their merchandise? You know, we always want to support the community first, you know, go maybe get away from the Amazon. So we'll put it out there.
If they have something like, what are your
specifics?
I'm trying to be all hot at night.
Right, so give me your specifics that you would
King
like.
King size.
King size. Go ahead.
Don't matter.
Is there color white? Okay. Is there a specific thread count you're looking for?
No. Well, I mean, hopefully, a 1,000 up.
1,000 up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. And that's it.
The higher, the better.
Cotton, Egyptian cotton.
Not that.
You know, what are you looking for?
I have my page there that I have. All the info saved.
You have all the info saved? Okay.
Yeah.
So if you're interested, hit us up. Go to the Moragne Media Group on Facebook and go ahead and inbox us. If you have a linen company or what would it be called? I'm not educated in that, so I apologize. Bed.
I don't know.
Well, that's your.
I just look for bed sheets.
There you go. That's all I'm asking.
You like a make motherfuckers
Well, you need to slow down, Bobby Valentino. I don't know. Listen, all that is in your cup tonight is some Coke Zero, some Myers rum.
I was about to like tell you to give me something sweet.
And
but then Marianne hit me up
and
with
some.
All right, really?
Go ahead, Marianne hit you up with what?
Nothing.
No. Go ahead. What'd she hit you up with?
Just go. First question.
No, go ahead. What did she hit you up with? That you guys got to go work out tomorrow or what?
Yeah, since Tony's going to be there.
Okay.
I was like, so then.
All right, so shout out.
I'm really going to get weighed.
Shout out to Combined Martial Science in Chino. That's where you do virtual classes at. So shout out to them. And if you're interested in the virtual classes, go ahead and just hit up Combined Martial Science on Instagram or Facebook, and they have Zoom classes for mixed martial arts, kickboxing, Muay Thai, and so go ahead and check them out. So yeah, you've still been doing well. You on your workout tips. I'm very proud of you. Very dedicated. We've both been, you know, dedicated more as of late. So you know, it definitely motivated me, babe, to get back on it. So I've been walking again in the whole nine. So appreciate you. Mm-hmm. And I love you for that, baby.
I love you too.
Yeah. So anything else before we get into some of these questions? Is there anything else you want to get off your chest? Anybody else you want to shout out?
No.
Mm-hmm. No? Okay.
Mm-mm. I don't think so.
No? You all right?
I'll probably remember it throughout the...
Okay, well, you know...
I don't know. Like, damn, I didn't know I needed notes.
You don't need notes. I'm just asking you before, you know, before we get into this.
You're like not being relevant to anything. Can you just go?
I'm not being relevant to anything. What the fuck?
Yeah. Just go.
Do you not want to be here? I mean, we could cut right now.
No, I do. But it's just you asking some stupid questions.
I'm just trying to spend time with you.
Well,
and what you're trying to do is get to the questions. All right, I got you. That means you must have some hot fire. You ready to go. That's what it is. You ready to go.
Something else in mind.
Okay. So I sent you some info. Oh, really? Mm-hmm. So I sent you some questions or some links earlier. And how would you feel if you found out that your ex-husband had been cheating on you while you guys were married by... seeing him in a newspaper with the announcement of him getting married to obviously the person he was cheating with. Mm-hmm. And you find all this out by reading, you know, Tom and Susie have been together for the 3 years.
Yeah, I read it. At first I was like, oh my goodness, this bitch. Like, this bitch ain't got, like, man, have a little more self-love, you know?
Right.
But then as I continue reading, because I don't usually read through everything.
Okay.
Oh,
okay.
So I just, you know, headline, but I was like, nah, because then the motherfucker might be testing me and shit. So I just read, I was reading, it said that he said he's never been married.
Yeah, he told her, he said that he'd never been married.
In the news or the article, right. Whatever the fuck.
So really quickly, like, let me just explain to the people listening what I'm talking about.
Fuck that shit.
So a female opens up a woman opens up the New York Times or whatever and sees that her ex-husband, recently divorced ex-husband, is getting married to someone. And in the bio or the blurb or whatever, it says that they have been together for X amount of years, which obviously was taking place when they were together. And then says, of course, that he's never been married, so doesn't acknowledge her. So she eventually reaches out to the lady and they have a conversation. And so how do you feel about that? That she reached out and contacted, the other lady? Because they end up having a kid or something like that.
Oh, they do have a kid?
They end up having a kid, yeah. If I'm not mistaken, they end up having a child.
I don't know. Like, you know what? Like, if they do have a kid, I think I just leave it alone. Just, you know, whatever. Like, karma's a motherfucker. So, just, you know, that's putting too much energy in it, you know?
Yeah.
So, I wouldn't do it. More pride too.
Well, I mean, not only is it pride, I just kind of think you just kind of move on, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know why you would have to be really hurt, I think, to do something like that. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? To lash out, to contact this person, you know what I mean? And the guy said, you know, basically, I'm happy with my family and I wish her the best. You know, so he basically sidestepped the whole entire thing. Old girl probably looked at it like, okay, who cares? You know what I mean? Obviously, she wasn't obviously she wasn't a factor. If she was someone you could hide from me, then obviously she wasn't that serious. And who knows how the dude spun it? And women are strong. Sometimes you guys will just eat something that might hurt you in the very beginning, but for the greater good, you kind of let go of it gradually. So I think it's crazy that she outed him, so to speak, you know. But that's what happens when you play those games. If you can't be up front with somebody, then, you know, you really can't tell how they're going to react when they find out that you were shady. Mm-hmm. At least if you're up front with somebody, they explode, you know, they're going to explode. But if you don't, you know, give them that opportunity and hide it, then you can't really control when it happens, how it happens, and, you know, there's no way. Sometimes you can't overcome that type of stuff, but just...
I wouldn't say shit. I'd just leave it. I'd be like, that's her problem now.
Yeah. Well, let me ask you this. Would it be different if you were happy? What if you were kind of single still, or what if you hadn't had a dude since him and, you know... Would that?
So I mean,
you don't think that plays a factor in it?
Maybe if I still loved him and I was all, you know, still fucking nuts for him.
Yeah.
Then I probably would do something. It's just that's the first thing.
So it just really depends on where you're at personally in that situation. If you're still hurt and you find that out, you're gonna react.
No, I mean, if I was single but happy,
yeah,
then I would just leave it.
Okay, but if you still have feelings,
like, if I still have feelings, most likely that's my instinct. That's you know.
So what would you do? Would you roll up on his, try to find his crib, or roll up on his crib, or would you roll up on the wedding day, or like,
Oh, no, that takes some plotting to think. Because you got to imagine every possible situation.
Right.
And how it plays out.
Okay.
So, you know.
Well, let's just go with one.
That's the reason I don't fucking sleep at night. And
what do you mean you don't sleep at night?
I'd be getting all these ideas.
What ideas?
Not just ideas of
like recipes?
Shit. No, just stupid shit.
Like what?
Shit that don't even make sense.
Well,
I don't
talk
know,
to me.
I can't
talk
tell
to me.
You.
Yes, you can. This is what I'm here.
I can't tell
oh,
you.
Oh, you don't remember?
Meaning. I don't remember right
oh,
now.
Oh, so you're just at night dreaming type of shit. Or
not
just
dreaming,
thinking.
Just thinking. Okay. Just plotting, well, just.
You know what you should do? You know what Biggie did? Biggie kept a cassette tape next to his bed. You can get up and just start talking
I ain't got
those
no more
ideas
battery
out.
On this shit. Like,
not
more.
On your phone. Get you one of them old cassette tapes.
Hey,
you just press say.
Fuck.
To capture what you're talking about. You might really have some good ideas. That's just me. I would go ahead and do that because you never know. You might have $1 million idea in your hand, boo.
Oh, no. But.
But yeah, that's.
I don't know. That's just wasting.
Nothing worse than a woman scoring. And dudes do. Let's not just put it on women. Dudes would do this too. A hurt dude would definitely out her on social media or something like that. Still probably follows her with a fake account. You know, there's a lot of that goes on. You know what I mean? And so those eyes will still be on you. You're living free. Like, hey, I'm free. And those eyes is lurking. Eyes is watching. You know what I mean? So, I don't disagree with it. If she was still hurt, I can understand it. But I think it's foul. If he moved on and had, you know, he has his family and she did it solely out of spite. Like, she doesn't care anymore. She just wanted to blow up his spot. I feel that's foul. So, we have been together almost what? We've been married now. Oh, we'll be married, what, 11 years in a couple mm-hmm. weeks, right?
Next week, baby.
Next week. No. There's a, yeah, next week.
Next weekend.
Next weekend, the 12th. So, there's a couple. Julio Cesar Mora and his wife, Walda Ramina Maclovia Quinteros.
You know that shit, old school.
Have been married for 79 years. Years. He is 110. She is 105. Making them the oldest couple in the world with a combined age of 214 years and 358 days. Amazing. Can you imagine being married that long to me? Could you do 79 more years
of this? No.
What do you mean of this?
Like, meaning like.
Damn, what do you mean? You said that so quick. You're like, no.
No, like, meaning. Meaning, because marriage is not just us. It's everything that really surrounds us. You know, with Tito in school and this,
right,
you know,
right.
Fucking crazy.
So you couldn't do
like,
79 years of homeschool?
And of, like, the whole.
Of what? COVID?
No, like, we hope to grow in time. Like, not only.
Maybe grow.
Not only in years, but, like, just being more wiser.
Okay.
And choosing shit, like, more wisely.
Okay.
So
talk to me.
You think that by, you know, when we're hit 40 years, things will be better.
Right.
You know, we won't have, not meaning that we argue over everything,
right.
But we argue over stupid shit.
Yeah, we
I mean,
argue
we
over
get
dumb
over
stuff.
It.
Right.
Like
right,
quickly.
Right.
That's one thing that we haven't been doing as, right. You know, as of late, as of Tito, now that he's
older.
No.
In school.
Since he's been here. Since he was born.
Okay.
That we really held grudges and.
Right, you know. Right. We try to get over stuff easily.
Yeah. So he.
Okay.
So I think it's yeah, it's been better, but it's just a little stupid shit. All
right.
You know, like you leaving your fucking socks laying around.
Right. And it's not major.
Your shoes in the middle. It's not major, but it's shit that can be like.
Nothing is going to be perfect.
I know
nothing is
going to
be perfect. If you're looking for the perfect husband.
But not, I know.
We
at
saw
this moment,
we saw in that Criminal Minds episode what happened.
It's not.
He was cutting those
up. Shut up. At this moment, it's not. But that's what I'm telling you.
Okay.
You know, 20 years from now, 10, no, I'm hoping not that long, but 10 years from now, hopefully we've evolved and we've gotten better.
Of course. We evolve every day, every week, I would say.
So that's all I'm saying. I'm sure they've lived more.
Yeah, you think Wilhelmina and old boy, that she don't think his breath stank every once in a while? And he don't like when she burned the chickens. You know what I mean? Like, I'm sure they've had their patches.
You know what?
Patches.
Fuck you.
And now, see, here you're getting mad. You know what I mean?
I'm getting mad because, yeah, I burned the chicken. That's because I was helping your son and fucking his homework and
great,
shit.
Great, I could have done it.
No.
But stop being all prideful Mary and shit. I could have went out there and done it. I want
to
walk.
So I'm like,
all
right, you know, he wants to walk. I ain't going to interfere that shit. I'll figure it out.
I could have came home and grilled it.
I didn't. This motherfucker wasn't listening. I was like, hey. Mm-hmm. Listen to me, like, you know, and little do I know that the teacher had sent something that they didn't have any homework today. So yesterday, so today's homework, yesterday's homework was to be done today.
And he did yesterday's homework.
So he's, you know, struggling because he's like, wait, what is it? I'm like, you did this today. She already explained it to you.
Yeah, but she did.
But she hadn't.
Yeah.
So then I was like, all right, I had to explain it to him in English. I'm like, I always explain to him in Spanish first two times. Then after that, I'm like, all right, you know what? Fuck this shit.
Uh-huh.
I'm like, this is what this, you know, means. And,
right.
And he'll, like, oh, okay. I
don't
know.
Okay.
So he.
But he got it done.
Yeah, he got it.
Okay.
And I mean, I don't know why I told her, I was like, I didn't get that message.
Right.
So I thought he was telling fibs. And she's like, oh, no, I did, you know, I did tell him. And I did post a message. But this shit's not notifying me.
You got to go in. Maybe can you reset the setting, download the app again or something? But no, I tore the chicken up. No, I mean, I grubbed.
He's over here like, mommy, I like it crispy like
this. Yeah, no, he was tearing off the little
cauliflower too.
He was tearing off the little burnt pieces and chewing on it like, daddy, this is good. I was like, you little nasty. But he was tearing up the cauliflower and the mushroom.
Cauliflower rice.
And the cauliflower rice, the mushroom, and the spinach.
Mushrooms for him next
Your mom said it didn't have any salt. So I was like, it was good to me. I wasn't tripping.
No, after that, I tried and I was like, yeah, she's right. So before I served you guys, I altered it again.
Oh, so when I got it, it was with salt?
Yeah.
Okay, because when I tried it, it was perfect to me.
I
couldn't taste it.
I was trying not to add more salt.
I couldn't taste it. Would you put the pink salt or the Himalayan or the pure salt?
I had put soy sauce. I ran out of the aminos.
Yeah.
So I had the soy sauce.
No wonder my feet feel blown up.
And I put soy sauce in there, and this is low sodium.
I mess with you.
But
remember that time we went to that sushi spot?
Yeah. Man,
I wish
we can go eat sushi.
I went in there, played myself, thinking I could eat some soy sauce. It was like one of them all-you-can-eat places, and I was grubbing. Next thing I know, my sandals got... Was it? Mm-mm. Okay, no. So we were just grubbing. Next thing I know, my sandals got tight and shit. Like, what the fuck? That shit was kind of scary.
They be putting that shit, like, I always had for the low sodium.
Yeah, I don't even use it anymore. You know me. I just kind of eat it with the wasabi. You know, I might use it on certain rolls, but for the most part, I just do my thing.
But yeah, watch. My hands won't be swollen tomorrow.
Why? From the
soy sauce?
Yeah. But you have a lot.
No, but still, I just...
It swells you up just a little bit, even though it was low sodium. Did you lose...
Well, no, it was low. I think that's the... No, that's still some of the regular one. I went to a store, they didn't have low sodium, so I bought a little one. And then I should have dumped it and then put the new one out, whatever. Yeah.
So I definitely hope I get 79 years with you, no matter much you infuriate me, no matter how much.
I never said I didn't.
Nah, you were like, no, could you do? You're like,
Not like this. Not
what
like
is like this?
This?
I don't understand.
Like this under the circumstances.
What's our circumstances? We have a home.
Yes.
We are happy. We love each other.
I'm eating burnt chicken. Because your son ain't paying attention to his teacher.
What does that have to do with our marriage?
I'm saying under the circumstances.
Oh, so you want...
Like right now it's a little tense because...
I got you. So you don't... Well, then we got to work on making this less tenseful. I'm here to help.
I'm getting there.
I'm here to help. Just, you just got to relinquish.
I'm getting, you know, the AC is... Hey, that shit's...
Cool. I'm glad I could come through in the clutch.
Have I thanked you?
Not really. Not really.
Well, I thank you.
You know
today.
How I like to be thanked. You haven't thanked me. But what I was going to tell you is this. Now that the AC is on, then, you know, you need to turn your temperature down, too.
I am.
All
right. Right now, we're not in AC. We're outside.
Outside? Yes, we are. We're al fresco for this episode of the Moragne.
Getting bit by mosquitoes and shit.
It feels good, though. We're getting life. It's ancestors. So, babe. We were talking about sex robots, right? Or sex dolls or whatever. I sent you this link to this dude. He is a bodybuilder slash actor out of somewhere out of Russia. And what my man has done is gotten himself a sex doll and has dressed her up and takes her around to restaurants and treats her like she's really alive. And said he's going to propose, or he's proposed to her and is going to marry her. His name is Yuri Tolochiko. You know, he's posing pictures together like they're a couple out. It's pretty wild. What do you think about that?
Like a loco.
You think this is a publicity stunt to get off, to get everything off? Because he's an actor and doing some other shit. Or do you think that he's really, he talks about her as if she really exists? I know there was a movie, and I forget, it was a Joaquin Phoenix movie, if I'm not mistaken, where I think it was called Real Girl or something like that. But what are your thoughts on people living with a sex doll and actually giving it a personality and treating it like it's real?
I don't know. I mean, what can they actually have gone through in life to not want that personal affection with the person? You know, it's just, I can't see myself. And I'm not saying it's bad, like, if that's what people like, then hey, that's them. But I'm saying is like, how I couldn't see myself like being with a plastic and shit.
Yeah, and maybe you're right. Maybe something has happened, or maybe it's just people feel like they can't connect.
Good, so.
Well, I'm sorry. What'd you say?
I said maybe because your dick too good.
Maybe they just feel like they can't connect with someone, and they feel like being with the doll and creating a perfect person. Because I think essentially that's what you're doing, is you're projecting your perfection or what you want in a partner into this doll. You know, it could be someone who's been hurt before in a very serious relationship, and you know, thinks that this is the alternative. I mean, I don't know. I don't get it myself. Like you said, I need skin. I need to feel you. I need to be able to cup your booty cheek. You know what I mean? I need to be able to do those things and feel that. Mm-hmm. And so, but I'm not knocking him. If that's what he does, that's what he does. If that's what fulfills him, then good to him. But yeah, definitely not anything that I could see myself doing. And I'm leaning to this being a publicity stunt. I don't really think that this is a real deal Holyfield.
And I'm just saying that because, yeah, that's what it is. Like, just because it ain't something I like means it's bad. Like, well, yeah, you know, pedophiles and shit like that, that's bad.
But ooh, Good segue.
But
speaking of pedophiles,
you swear I do that shit on purpose.
Now you must. I must have cue cards up for you. Speaking of pedophiles, your boy Robert.
Everything.
Your boy Robert, except the temperature on the AC. Your boy Robert Sylvester Kelly.
Invite you to the fucking thing.
Your boy Robert Sylvester Kelly was attacked in prison. Allegedly, they tried to stab him, stomp him in his head. And now he wants to be released because his life is in danger and he also has fear of COVID. So, Mimi Moraney, how do you feel about your boy Kellz wanting to come home?
Those girls' life were in danger too. Did he give a fuck?
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
Those girls' lives were in danger too. Did he give a fuck? Nah,
he didn't.
Like, this motherfucker needs to stay there.
Yeah.
Do his time.
So, do you think he should...
you scared now.
Do you think he should be in some sort of protective custody? Or do you think he should be out there?
If you want to be a bitch and do that, then hey, go ahead.
I mean,
if that's what you want.
Obviously, they're trying to kill him. I mean, he
like I said, karma's a bitch.
Right. I have no sympathy. I'm just saying, isn't him going to protective custody the smart move?
Probably, and that's probably what he's going to have to end up doing.
Right.
If he wants to live.
I think for the sake of his children, he should go to protective custody. I have no sympathy for him. I do have sympathy for his children, mm-hmm. though, because he has children. And for the sake of his children, he should go to protective custody and serve out whatever time he gets. But I have no sympathy for him being attacked. Of course, you've done things that have provoked feelings in people. You know what I mean? There's people who, and this abuse happens in every family, but abuse also happens at a higher rate in families who have members of the family who have been incarcerated and have had long stays in the prison system, violent behavior, whatever that may be. So there's a lot of brothers that have sisters or cousins who have been abused by whoever. So there's a lot of anger behind that. And if he's out there in general population, he's definitely going to have a target on his head. So in my opinion, he should be in protective custody for the sake of his children. But that's just me. What do you think about these people who are out there marching for him, saying, hey, free this guy. He deserves to be free. You know, this is an injustice that's happened. Like, they have...
injustice?
They had people marching outside of the prison he was being held at.
I mean... have you talked to these women?
No. Well, I don't know if they interviewed them or whatnot.
You can't just... I mean, that's somebody's feelings. But it's just... I don't know. I mean... they have the right to do so.
Right.
But...
it just doesn't make any sense, in my opinion.
I guess.
Yeah.
I guess it's just... I don't think they would feel the same way if it was one of their family members.
Oh, of course not. Of course not. If it hits home, close to home, that's when people change the way they feel about stuff. It's always cool until, you know, you found out that it happened to someone that you, you know, have love for.
Mm-hmm.
So... you saw the story about the mother in Brazil who was invited to the fake bridal shower and then was killed
baby
in the or the baby shower and then
yeah.
and was killed and their best friend took the baby.
That's fucked up.
That is crazy. Like, I don't understand why some people just don't go another route. Or is it a mental... is there some sort of mental disease that...
I think she was probably... I mean... because she had a miscarriage and shit.
So she had something that triggered that.
Yeah. And I mean, but for her boyfriend, her or her husband to be with it, like,
oh, he
I
helped
don't know,
out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like,
well, trauma makes you do crazy shit sometimes.
I don't know, but you tell me, you hit me up and be like, babe, like, let's take such and such baby. How would I be okay with that?
No, and why would I ask you to do that?
No, that's what I'm saying.
You can barely handle the baby we got.
There has to be one sane one. Right. There has to be one sane person, you know?
Oh, yes, that's me. I'm definitely the sane one in the relationship.
I'm not saying in us.
Yes.
I'm saying, like, you know what?
What? Tell me. Tell me what you want. Did you like Drew Hill?
I think so.
You think so? But, so back to the story. The baby survives, right?
Mm-hmm.
Did the mother survive or she died?
No, she died.
She died. That's sad. So the baby then goes to hopefully somebody
gets
in the family.
Hit her with the brick.
Ooh. That's
not only did they fucking tear her stomach open.
They hit her with a brick.
Yeah.
Could you imagine that? Your last moments on this earth are your child being ripped from your stomach mm-hmm. by people that you thought loved you.
Mm-hmm.
That's some evil shit right there, man. That's some evil shit. Definitely, everybody is not your homie. Everybody's not your friends. You know, you gotta.
That's for sure.
Really, really, really gotta thank and bless those that you know who are very true and solid around you, because it's very few and far between.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and these stories like that unfortunately highlight what's really going on.
Yeah. So fucked up shit out there.
So, we normally do a segment called Things That I Would Never Fuck With. So right before we were recording or set to record, and I was lagging or my low budget, my low budget technology you're saying earlier?
I said your unprofessional ass.
My unprofessional ass. So, me being unprofessional, I was going through, you know, some possible topics. And what I came across was Kellogg's is coming out with a line, or actually is out. I think it's out in stores already. A line of Latino flavored cereals. And I wanted to get your take on these. So you saw the one that was, what was it called, my love? Pan de Muerto.
Mm-hmm.
Is that something you're interested in?
I'm not a big fan of pan de muerto.
But
I'll try the churro one.
There was a churro one, and there was also a cinnamon roll one. Pan de rolo de, what is it called? Help me out, babe.
I forgot.
Hold on, let me go ahead and find that. So you don't think it's whack that Kellogg's doing that? Do you think it's actually pretty fly, or do you think this is them, as always, trying to capitalize on?
Tell me what one company that's big company like doesn't ever try to capitalize. They want their money.
Of course. I'm not saying that.
You know, but what I, you know, as a Latina.
Uh-huh.
I would try it.
Yeah.
I want to be the first one to say, shit's whack. You know, but hey, if it's good, oh, shit.
So it's Kellogg's Pan de Muerto. There's also Kellogg's Churros, mm-hmm. as well as Rolos de Canela.
Rollos de Canela.
Yeah, so cinnamon rolls, basically.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess the... it's the pan de muerto isn't that a, it's a type of pan dulce, right?
It's
that's like the cross bun.
Yeah.
With the sugar on top.
Yeah, it's
if they can freak that and get that density into each one of the little because they look like they're, so the churros are actually the shape of churros, and then the pan de muerto are little flat. They look like flattened kicks. I'm looking at some pictures here. And then the cinnamon rolls, the rolas de canela, those look like actual little cinnamon rolls. So it's available definitely at Walmart and some other places as well. You have some people who are saying this is just more cultural appropriation, but you have no issue with it since you are the 100%... Latino over there that can speak on it. Only 50% of my vote counts.
I guess because I'm a cereal head. I like cereal.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, I mean, I don't really eat it now.
Yeah.
Because I gotta eat healthy cereal and shit.
Yeah, but we could pause for one bowl just to check it out. We could if you want to, let's get a bowl and we could do a review on the next episode. How about that?
Mm-hmm.
So we'll do that. I'll let you choose since again you're the full blooded, and you know I'm in the closet, the grandma in the closet, which is a dope ass series on PBS. If you haven't ever seen it before, go ahead and Google Black Grandmother in the Closet PBS, and it's gonna take you across Latin America and South America, and it's going to give you the experience and the stories of Africans and the integration through the slave trade through all outs, you know, the Caribbean, Central America, South America, and Mexico. Really dope series. So go ahead and check that out on PBS. It's actually, I think, on YouTube. But we should definitely pick a box. I'll let you pick a box. Two boxes maybe, and or if you want to get all three, and then we'll try a bowl and we'll post a review. You with it?
Sure.
All right, that sounds super dope. So
I'll make it, I'm gonna make sure to count it into my calories.
Yeah, count it definitely into your calories. So, anything before we get out of here, love?
Nope.
That's it. All right. Well, I appreciate you. I feel like you weren't really, you were forced to do this episode. I kind of felt like. Yeah. Huh?
I can't control your feelings, can I? Yeah, those are your feelings, not mine. Right?
I guess.
I mean.
You mean what?
I'm here, aren't I?
You are. But why aren't you, why are you not talkative? Talk to me.
It's been a long week.
All right, what was long?
No, it's just like, I mean, it's been long. It's just been, I don't know, like I wanted to end already. Want to get over this day and be ready. I'm ready to have a few days off.
Okay, and we got that coming.
And I want Monday to get here.
Yeah.
I want to just kill it on Monday.
Well, can we just enjoy the weekend first? Can we see? I think what you're doing is you're projecting. You're constantly thinking ahead.
It's just it's not. It's
for
gonna
this
be,
time that
this week is gonna be short, and I know it. I gotta.
Yeah, it's gonna be a short week.
On laundry.
But this weekend, let's vibe. Let's chill. You got the AC. You know what I mean?
We can bust some movies. Jimmy's gonna be here. Oh, he's gonna want to get in the pool. I ain't getting in the pool with 116 degree
yes,
fucking
you
weather.
You gotta get in the pool with 116.
I'll get in and then I'll get out.
Come on, babe. Yeah, come out with me.
You
looking
know me,
all
I'm
good.
Gonna fry and shit. I'm gonna be
come
like
on,
a chicharron.
Baby. No, no, you're looking like you got a beautiful brown skin.
No, I don't mind that. What I mind is just skin. It's the sun beaming on me and giving me migraines. I don't like that.
Get you one of them little floppy hats and you can be in the pool.
I ain't gonna
like
get us even tan.
Like you from the 60s or the 50s or whenever they wore floppy hats and got in the water. Stay under the tent. That's why I got a little tent in the pool.
Because I know next weekend we're going to be in Palm Springs too.
And that's what's going to be hot. And that's when you're going to have to really have your sun endurance up. So that's what I'm saying. Work on your tan now. So next weekend you good.
So what you going to grill? What you going to make?
This weekend?
Yeah.
This weekend I'm going to
I want something special for me.
For
ooh,
you.
I got the scallops, baby.
Yeah, this weekend what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a twofer. I'm going to smoke some ribs. And then on the side I'm going to do a seafood, like butter, garlic, kind of saute. So I'll take some of the scallops. I'll take some of that marisco mix that we have in there. I want to buy some shrimp. Throw some shrimp in there. And throw some.
I think my mom's going to the store tomorrow.
So get some butter. Get some nice garlic. Chop that up. You know, pepper, salt, or whatever. Put it in the sartén over here.
Sartén.
And just start swirling that motherfucker.
That's so high in calories.
No, that doesn't. No, 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 because it's only butter, garlic, and that's it. And then you're just putting the seafood. Nah, well, you know. Then you just put the seafood. And then the ribs we'll do keto style. You know? So that'll be the plate. Some ribs with a seafood little saute on the side. It's going to be fire. Perfect compliment. If you could do a little slaw, something, you know, something that a dressing that's not too, no sugar, no nothing in it or whatever. Something simple like you used to do, you know. Maybe something acidy to fight the fat from the butter and
I'll see. I don't know.
The pork. But yeah,
I'll work with what I have.
You always do, baby. You always do. But I'm looking forward to this weekend. I'm looking forward to the following weekend after that. So, you know, positive vibes, positive vibrations is really what we're looking for. You know.
I guess I'm just excited for next week.
Yeah, so just take it one day at a time. Don't think about it ahead of time. So if you think about it ahead of time, it's not going to get here, you know, quick enough. And you're going to be disappointed by any little ups and downs you might have. So just take it day by day. And you know what? Plan. Get ready. Do I have this already? Cool. Do I have this already? Cool. Because that's how you think. So plan and knock out these things leading up to the day. So up to the day of packing or up to the day of whatever, you're not running around like a chicken with your head caught off trying to do everything. Well, we can knock stuff out early. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's what I'm going
to
do.
You know, like for instance, like someone goes to the store now, we could buy the waters that we're going to take to take out there. You know what I mean? So that way we don't have to stop anywhere. We just already got them in the whip.
Water. They have filtered water.
I'm just saying, what if we want you know, some water.
You mean we need to take the alcohol?
Yeah, we can get the alcohol ready and put the alcohol, whatever alcohol we're taking, we can put it in there. But we wanted to buy some wine, though.
Yeah, but I want some.
You trying to get some hard liquor?
Mm-hmm.
I'm just trying to chase you around the house naked on Friday. Let's play house. Shout out to Nate Dogg. Rest in peace, man. So, all right, babe. Anything else before we get out of here? I see you feeling good.
No, nothing.
Nothing. Anybody want to shout out? Say peace too. No. All right. Well, shout out to all the family and friends that listen in. Big ups to RJ and his wife for checking us out. Michael Contra, big shout out to you, man. Just everybody for supporting us. We really appreciate it. You have been listening to The Moranis. You can go ahead and find us via an honest conversation about hip hop on Spotify. And you can also go ahead and find us on our Facebook page, The Moraney Group. So check us out. Download us. And,
we got a Facebook.
Huh? Yes, we have a Facebook page. Why would we not have a Facebook page?
Okay, wrap it up. I'm getting bit over here.
Mosquitoes biting because you got that dulce. You got that whap.
About to have that dulce too. Ooh. So go ahead.
Okay.
Finish.
So
bye.
That bye peace. Thank you. Check it out. I'm gone.
Adios.
About to get the draws, dog.